today's class we shall see the energy of plane progressive wave. We shall also see the intensity of the plane progressive wave, and also we shall see the distribution of energy over a complete wavelength in a plane progressive wave. Now the sum of the kinetic energy and the potential energy of a vibrating particle remains the same. That is, if the kinetic energy is maximum, then the potential energy is zero, and if the potential energy is maximum, then the kinetic energy is zero. So what is the equation of a progressive wave? It's given by y equal to a sine 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, where a is the amplitude, lambda is the wavelength, v is the velocity of the wave, t is the time, and x is the position. Therefore, the kinetic energy per unit volume will be given by half rho dy by dt whole square. Rho is the density of the medium. Mass per unit volume. So what is dy by dt? Dy by dt is equal to a 2 pi by lambda v cos 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. Therefore, kinetic energy per unit volume is equal to half rho, and in place of dy by dt we shall write a square 4 pi square by lambda square v square cos square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, and this is your equation number 1. So let us write this equation number 1 so that we can use it afterwards also. Now what is potential energy per unit volume? Let us find it. This is equal to Y. Therefore, potential energy per unit volume is equal to rho omega square y dy for displacement dy, and the total potential energy per unit volume over the displacement y is given by integration 0 to y rho omega square y dy, and this is equal to half rho omega square y square. What is the value of omega? Omega we know is equal to k into v, where k is the wave number and v is the velocity of the wave. And y is equal to a sin 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. Therefore, potential energy per unit volume is equal to half rho omega square. So omega square can be written as k into v, and this k into v is 2 pi by lambda v, because k is the wave number and which is equal to 2 pi by lambda. So this is equal to half rho omega square is equal to 4 pi square by lambda square v square, and y square is a square sin square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. So this is equation number 2. This is the potential energy per unit volume. Let us again write it here. Is equal to half rho 4 pi square by lambda square v square a square sin square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. This is equation number 2. Therefore, the total energy per unit volume is the sum of the potential energy and the kinetic energy. So this is equal to half rho 4 pi square by lambda square v square, a square, and this is the common, and inside the bracket they have cos square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x plus sin square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, and this is equal to half rho 4 pi square by lambda square v square a square, and this is equal to 2 rho pi square, and v by lambda is the frequency n. So v square by lambda square is equal to n square and a square. So this is our equation number 3. This is the total energy per unit volume of a plane progressive wave. Now let us define intensity. So what is intensity? Intensity is the rate of transfer of energy per unit area, and the area is perpendicular to the direction of the propagation. So intensity the rate of transfer of energy per unit area, the area being perpendicular to the direction of propagation. So if you consider a tube of unit cross sectional area, and if V be the length, remember this V is the velocity of the wave. So in 1 second the distance traveled is V. Therefore this volume will be V into 1, that is V. Therefore the energy per unit area is equal to this total energy per unit volume into the volume, and therefore the intensity will be in this case is equal to 2 rho pi square n square a square into V. This is our intensity in this case. Now let us make some space. Now we shall see the distribution of energy over a complete wavelength. Now, the kinetic energy per unit volume is equal to half rho a square 4 pi square v square by lambda square cos square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x, and this is equal to 4 rho a square 2 pi square, in place of v by lambda we write n square cos square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x. Therefore the kinetic energy over the complete, the average kinetic energy over the complete wavelength is given by 1 by lambda 0 to lambda rho a square 2 pi square n square cos square 2 pi by lambda dt minus x dx. Now take the common out, or rather the constants out. We have got 1 by lambda rho a square 2 pi square n square 0 to lambda cos square 2 pi lambda by lambda vt minus x dx. So this is the value of the kinetic energy over the complete wavelength. This is the average kinetic energy over the complete wavelength. Now let us find the value of cos square 2 pi by lambda vt minus x dx. So let us write it somewhere so that we can use it. The value of the average kinetic energy over complete wavelength is 1 by lambda rho a square 2 pi square n square 0 to lambda cos square 2 pi by lambda t minus x dx. Let us find the value of cos square 2 pi by lambda t minus x dx from 0 to lambda. So this is equal to half 0 to lambda 1 plus cos 4 pi by lambda bt minus x and this is dx. Here we have used this trigonometric identity cos square theta is equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. So this is equal to half, and the first term is 0 to lambda dx plus half 0 to lambda cos 4 pi by lambda vt minus x dx. This is equal to lambda by 2 plus half, and this is equal to minus lambda by 4 pi sine 4 pi by lambda vt minus x, and this integration is from 0 to lambda, the value of the limits. So this is equal to lambda by 2 plus half minus lambda by 4 pi, and we have got sine 4 pi by lambda vt minus lambda minus sine 4 pi by lambda vt minus 0. Solving it, we have this equal to lambda by 2 plus half and minus lambda by 4 pi, and inside we have got sine 4 pi by lambda v minus 4 pi minus sine 4 pi by lambda v t. Now this is equal to lambda by 2 plus half minus lambda by 4 pi. We expand it, sine 4 pi by lambda dt cos 4 pi sine a minus b minus sine 4 pi cos 4 pi by lambda vt minus sine 4 pi by lambda Vt. So the value of cos 4 pi is 1. So sin 4 pi by lambda Vt into 1 is sin 4 pi by lambda Vt, and there is minus sin 4 pi by lambda Vt. So these two cancels out, and the value of sin 4 pi is 0. So this whole is 0. So we are left with only the first term, that is equal to lambda by 2. Therefore, the average kinetic energy over complete wavelength is given by over complete wavelength is equal to 1 by lambda rho a square 2 pi square n square, and we have found out this value cos square 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x dx, the integration from 0 to lambda is equal to lambda by 2. So this lambda and lambda cancels out, and this 2 and 2 gets cancelled out. So we get the average kinetic energy over complete wavelength is equal to rho a square pi square n square. Now the potential energy, the potential energy per unit volume is given by is equal to half rho 4 pi square by lambda square v square a square sin square 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x, and this is equal to rho 2 pi square n square a square sin square 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x, where a is the frequency, which is equal to V by lambda. Therefore, the average potential energy over the complete wavelength will be given by 1 by lambda 0 to lambda rho 2 pi square n square a square sin square 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x dx. Now taking the constants out, we have got 1 by lambda rho 2 pi square n square a square 0 to lambda sin square 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x dx. And solving this, we get this value is equal to lambda by 2. We can solve it as we have solved for 0 to lambda integration cos square 2 pi by lambda Vt minus x dx, and we'll get this value as equal to lambda by 2. So we get average potential energy over complete wavelength is equal to 1 by lambda rho 2 pi square n square a square and lambda by 2. So again 2 cancels out, lambda and lambda cancels out. So we are left with rho pi square n square a square. So we can write average P over the complete wavelength is equal to rho A square pi square N square. The total average energy is equal to the sum of the average potential energy and the average kinetic energy, and this is given by 2 rho A square pi square N square total average energy over the complete wavelength. Therefore, from here we can see kinetic energy average is equal to potential energy average is equal to rho A square pi square N square, and this is equal to half total average energy. So we see at any instant of time the average kinetic energy over the complete wavelength is equal to the average potential energy over the complete wavelength, and these two are equal to half of the total average energy. So we stop here.